wanna dance, dick and they stop a friend.
Adam Family.
They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, dick and they stop a friend.
Adam Family.
It was a challenge in one aspect. I wanted to see how could I capture the essence of Hammer and the essence of the movie without compromising, and they both came together very nicely. Videos that Rupert Wainwright has directed, which he's done all of my videos in one aspect or another, he's done them all. They have been the very, you know, backbone of Hammer. Hammer comes over on video very well, and Rupert is responsible for that in a big way. His contribution to Hammer is extensive.
All right, Hammer and I met, no sheer coincidence. He was doing a video down in San Diego.
Hammer time!
And he called me up out of the blue, pretending to be from Capitol Records. You know, before I heard the track and met him and everything, it was just like, well, you know, I gotta do this thing. And then once we met and we started working, it was very exciting. Everyone got really excited about it, and, you know, bang, off we went.
I'm into loyalty, you know, and if it ain't broke, I don't fix it. You know, a lot of people would have gotten into this position and try to switch to a bigger name director, but I felt as though Rupert always caught my vision. I wanted to show loyalty to him and stick with him. And he's also shown a lot of loyalty to me and been there for me.
I take care of one thing and he takes care of someone else. And he doesn't want to trust anyone else to the dance because he just wants to cut the dance himself. So that's all there is to it. And I'll take care of how it's shot and coverage and cutaways and dreaming up more stuff. And then meanwhile, he knows that because of our relationship, he knows that like he'll be in there cutting the dancing and then I'll cut everything else around that.
Boom. Boom. If we can get that.
So that, you know, it's a kind of like the right hand and left hand thing. And, you know, we've kind of worked that out pretty much. But the one thing that he's absolutely dogmatic about is about the air, you know, his dance steps and stuff like that.
And when I come through, y'all don't start right away. See, I got to catch on to y'all rhythm first, see? Now I yell it, hit me, bow, bow. So you got to be listening. Or would y'all prefer me to be like this and say, bah. Y'all wouldn't see it. Y'all would see it. I mean, y'all see it, but it might throw you off.
And no one decides that but him.
The good thing is that we don't really ever clash on ideas in terms of the filming of the video. It's just in the editing where we fight all the time. It's like we fight in the editing so much because I'm pulling for the right dance moves and dancing, and he's pulling for cinematography shots. You know, did you see that face, the way it fell? Isn't that great, Hammer? Oh, look it right there. Oh, love that trolley shot, you know? And I'm sorry, man, look here. That trolley shot, I haven't seen anybody do the trolley yet. You know, I'm trying to get some dances out here and some energy. So we fight, and in the end, you see a balanced video.
Yeah, this is my first music video, and it was a lot of fun doing it. I got to sword fight with the Hammer.
We knew that Raoul was going to be there, and that was about it. And we knew that there would be swords. You know, we'd set this thing up with Angelica and Hammer, like, you know, seducing each other and Raoul watching, and then with a flourish of the sword. So I thought, well, this would be fun to have a sword fight, but I didn't know whether Hammer could carry it off. Raoul is a trained theatrical actor, so he knew a lot about sword fighting, and Hammer's, you know, naturally athletic and coordinated. He picked that up pretty quickly.
Shoulder, leg, head, and yeah.
The minute we got out there, we talked. Yeah, you know, he got into it. We made up our sword fight routine, and we were having fun with it. He makes suggestions and jokes on, you know, what to do. The part when we come together was his idea to come together, and then my idea then to look at the camera, you know. And so we did a lot of things together.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
He's another actor who didn't have the ego problem, and he was just being himself. He's an extreme professional. You know, he was able to have fun and everything, but execute.
So
He clearly was having fun. I mean, his character has a lot of fun in this movie, so that was part of it.
Hammer gets to kiss Morticia, and I get very jealous because I'm crazy about the woman.
Give us playback, Kenny, for rehearsal.
They wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they slap a friend. They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they slap a friend.
I was attempting to do some dancing with his posse members. Of course, it's very hard to keep up with them because they're very fast.
He danced along with the dancers, and he just got loose.
They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they slap a friend. They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they slap a friend.
I don't think there's a future in rap for me, but if anybody wants to invite me to do a little bit, I'll be glad to do it. But I don't think there would be much of a future in the rap business for me.
Christopher Lloyd is like a shy type of guy. And, you know, once Raul came over there and we all got together, he opened up more, and he just is really, you know, real cool dude, you know. And he fit right in with the characters that Raul and I had taken on, you know, within the context of the video, so it was great.
He's really a great guy, professional, cool, kind, and we just had a good time.
There are no words to describe Raul, period. He is so down to earth, so fun. It was like being with a friend. I fell in love with Angelica Houston on the set. She was just such a nice person.
We thought it was good.
The outfit that she had on was kind of painful to her, you know, that she had to go through, but she remained so nice through it all, and laughing and having a good time. And she showed a whole lot of character and a whole lot of professionalism, and just it was fun. You know, she left smiling and joking, and we had a good time. We played around with each other a lot and everything. It was fun.
Yeah. Oh, this is the Addams Groove right here.
Angelica Houston's interesting because she'll do a scene and she'll be like, you got me make a decision. She's very quiet, she's very controlled. And then you roll the cameras and she goes crazy. You know what I mean? So it's very bizarre. You don't necessarily know what you're going to get, but you have a suspicion it's going to be really good. And 9 times out of 10 it is, which is kind of comforting. She knows what she's going to give you or whatever, and you roll and you get a little jam, which is great. But it was interesting to work, you know, very interesting to work with her, and a real delight.
Cameron's a good dancer, and he's a great person.
I found it delightful to work with the kids. You know, that was some of the biggest pluses of the entire video, working with little Jimmy and Christina. There's something special about kids, you know, for me, that I just enjoy working with them.
Shot, take one.
I really like working with children. I think I'm probably my mental age is somewhat slightly lower than most of the children I work with. They're both very talented in, you know, in different ways.
I like little Jimmy, that's my friend.
My name's Jimmy, and my character's name is Pugsley in the movie Addams Family.
He's a real live character. And little Christina, she's a gorgeous little girl, and she played that character to a T.
Wednesday, my character. She's very solemn, and she doesn't like to show her emotions. She's like suspicious, always suspicious, and very mysterious. In the movie, I went after Pugsley. In the video, I went after Hammer. I had already dealt with Pugsley, now I'm going after a bigger and better game.
When I heard I was going to be in a video with Hammer, I'm just like, ah, all and just jumping around the room. We did a whole bunch of stuff like dancing, sitting on a tombstone couch. We sang our little song, sitting on the couch. We're saying, they do what they want to do, say what they want to say, live how they want to live, play how they want to play, dance how they want to dance, kicking their slap friend, and that's the Addams family.
As dancers, Christina is the quicker one. She can pick up on the moves a lot faster than Jimmy can. And Jimmy is the one who has the most outrageous moves.
Before we start a shot, he'd make up something for us to do.
Their dancing wasn't very good.
Let's see you do it.
Ah, Rupert's dancing abilities.
They do what they want to do.
Okay, they do what they want to.
He needs more work.
Live how they want to live.
Usually a lot of the other people, they just like, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. The Hammer, he's really nice. It was lots of fun.
It was a lot of fun working with Hammer. I mean, he's a great guy.
I enjoyed it. There's something special about kids, you know, for me, that I just enjoy working with them. There was a difference between the music video version and the trailer version, some because the Motion Picture Association wouldn't approve certain things that were special effects that we put into the music video version, like the part of my head being cut off and rapping the lyrics as it rolls along.
The basic problem was to build a three-dimensional head of Hammer, capture his rap, and then bounce it through the frame. We started by making a three-dimensional wireframe like you can see here. The next task becomes to get the painting of the head, if you will, wrapped completely around this three-dimensional object. Then we took that and bounced it through the scene using three-dimensional computer animation. Then we composited the 3D head into the original live-action footage, and it looked like this.
Rupert likes to move the camera, and we had this techno crane. It's like a camera with wings. It just floats all over the set. I loved it. It was a great piece of equipment. So you could put the camera almost anywhere you wanted in a couple of minutes,
right?
And then make it move up and down and in and out at sort of just like that.
There's a certain amount of practical effects that are done, like there's the guillotine that seems to execute Hammer but doesn't. Obviously that was something that we were like kind of keen to test before we put, you know, one of the highest selling entertainment artists of the world into this thing. So that was something that I had a certain amount of trepidation about.
Alright, you got that on both sides.
Let's go with me, let's go.
No, do you want to just sit in and we'll...
Yeah, let me do one part
he'll sit in one. All the way down.
I can see it's gonna do it. I don't want you to do that because you're putting strain on it. See what I'm saying? Yeah, he is. Because if it don't break these first two times, that could have been a tape. Don't you take up none of my security. I got it. I believe in it.
Then there was the wheel of torture.
Max, relax.
Which I had tested in advance and fallen off and ended up at the chiropractor to prove that it was completely unsafe.
Are we still spinning? Because if we not, I can handle it, but them extra turns you get, you're wasting film and you ain't going to use them. This thing can't take it, I'm telling you. It's like, I can pull them out right now.
Now I didn't enjoy that much at all. So then there was the whole effect of him popping out of the table in the dining room scene. That took a long time to do because we had to cut a hole in the table, then I cut a hole in the platter, and then put mylar underneath, and then all this food on top, and then the food kept on drying out, and the mylar kept showing, and his neck would show, and that was very hard work, and very time-consuming, and very tedious.
Okay. You can try that with the table.
Not yet. Don't cut me, Rupert. Just get back.
And then there were a whole lot of special effects afterwards, like for example when the kids crawl underneath the table and look at Hammer when he's not there.
So you're looking at Hammer's head and you're going, I bet you this is a trick. Let's go under the table and have a look to see if he's there. No, you're thinking that, okay? So you maybe look at each other and go like, point underneath.
I needed the ball, a little bit of pepper, my chicken. The next thing you know, coming in deep was a hand with the fingers I stepped. Now I tried to play it on off.
Thing, of course, Thing, yeah, there's a couple of shots which I really love of Thing like walking around the table.
My participation in special effects is, once you get it together, let me see it. Rupert would go in and make a few changes, then he'd bring me in and let me see it, and then we'd, you know, say, yeah, that looks good. I don't know.
Yeah, take it way down.
I know what you're saying. Just get
real
with it.
Just
get it
kind of
over, bizarre, somewhere else. Okay, yeah.
Right.
Good to go.
Good to go.
Yeah, guys,
it's great.
We had a good time, you know. I enjoy my work, and I enjoyed the work they were doing, and we got to know each other, and we would sing and dance and, you know, just have fun while we work.
It ain't easy being Tom.
Definitely do what they want to do. Say what they want to say. Live how they want to live. And they play how they want to play.
Say what they want to say. Live how they want to live. Play how they want to play. Dance how they want to dance. Kick and they stop a friend.
Yes, he looks good. Yeah.
When Lurch does it, he's going to be real slow. Then he's going to look. Then we'll shoot him at 4 frames a second.
Oh,
it's incredible.
Oh, great.
Yeah. See? Yeah.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, this is Addams Groove right here. Yeah. Just like that.
You know what I mean? Lurch should catch it at one time and then blow him away.
Right, exactly.
Slow, yeah. Almost there, yeah. There, almost there, and then like,
we took dancers from different parts of the countries, from some from small obscure areas and some from, you know, large areas. But the dancers are not really popular. And we take these dances and we add to them and we change things up here and change things up there to come up with a new creation. I began dancing on the streets. So when I'm dancing in that alley, I got the best of both worlds as far as memories go. Here I am back on the streets in this alley. Now it's time to dance and get loose like I used to.
Now, see, we got the place dumping. I told you that I felt like starting something. Pump up, stomp up, make your body jump up. Suck the glass doodle when your life is gonna blow up. Moving and grooving, that's what we're doing. Nothing negative because your mind will be ruined. Aim for the top and go straight up in them. I never let them stop you when you're gaining momentum. Yeah.
Gaining momentum.
I've always been excited about music and dancing and, you know, rap. Since rap has been around, it is comparable to any, if not above, any form of music. We're not a singing group. We're a hybrid. You know, we are a new form of rap. It combines singing and rapping and, you know, the live instrumentation, things like that. But nevertheless, when it all comes down to it, we are considered a rap group by many. But yet, in this setting, you begin to understand how strong and powerful this art form that we have is.
They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they stop a friend. They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they stop a friend.
Yeah, thank you, Fester. I need to go back to the bridge just here. Thank you, thank you. Now check this out.
They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they stop a friend. They do what they wanna do, say what they wanna say, live how they wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they stop a friend.
That's a wrap.
What we ended up with, I think works very well for the movie. And I'm really proud of the piece.